Hello everyone and welcome back to Pixelmon Nuzlocke. Last time we left off we had caught ourselves a second Sneasel. I have since gone ahead and leveled her up a little bit. So let's give her a name, shall we? So let's see, she's a dark type, dark ice type. For some reason the name Shade just came to mind. So there you go, we have Shade. Shade at level 31. I mean, it's not a purely female name, but I could see it being a unisex name. Alright, so what I want to do today, and I believe my headphones are in a little funky. There we go, better. Okay, what I want to do today is I want to go back to the Sneasel Cold Taiga here. And I actually want to get together, hopefully, get together what I need to evolve our Sneasel into a Weavile. I'm not a huge fan of Weavile, personally. I prefer Sneasel over Weavile. But the fact of the matter is, we need some survivability, and evolution is the easiest way to get that. So, that's what's going to happen. So, yeah. So, we are going to go. We are going to look for another Sneasel. And we're going to start fighting Sneasels. We'll probably end up leveling up Salamam a whole ton while we're there. I don't know that we have anything else that's very particularly strong against Dark and Ice. We don't have a fighting type. Don't have a bug type. Is steel good against ice? That's a good question. That's a very good question. I can't remember. I don't think it is, but it might. Okay. Oh, hello. So we got two Sneasel Cold Taigas, so let's go over to this one. Sounds a little quiet. Music should kick in, hopefully, eventually. Phew. I should probably honestly consider starting to look at some royalty-free music that I can just layer under all my stuff. That would be not royalty free. What's the word I'm looking for? Is that the word I'm looking for? Royalty. What do you call music that's you don't have to license to use? I think they call it royalty free. I remember always finding that weird. Okay, so we kind of gotta wait until nightfall. So while we wait. I believe we have, let's see, what moves do you have again? Metal Claw, Faint Attack, Metal Claw and Faint Attack. Did I catch anything in this biome over here? I believe I have all my waypoints on. All my catches on, yeah, that's for sure. Miltank. That's where I caught Miltank? Really? And what did I catch over here? A Hoppip. Oh. Okay. Whatever. I'm getting north and south mixed up, evidently. But that does mean that I can fight in this plains biome with Sneasel easily enough. Should be able to find some grass types or something. I don't know. And then we can fly back up north when night hits. And start hunting some Sneasels for some claws. I believe they give grip claws, and then I have to combine those together to get a something. Another type of claw, I just can't remember what it's called. Or is Grip Claw what I need? No, I don't think Grip Claw is what I need. I think Grip Claw is the components, if I'm not mistaken. Charizard sounds really grumpy. Something wrong, buddy? Something up? We need to talk? Is this talking time? Does talking time need to happen? Man, no grass types, really? Not much of anything, honestly. I'm also thinking it might be worth considering swapping out Tumbelina for someone else. Because we've got ground type covered with Drago. It might be time to consider bringing someone new into the party. As far as type coverage goes, I'm not quite sure what else we would bring in, though. While we do technically have a flying type with Gyarados, I don't know that Gyarados, let's call her Wanda, because that's her name. I don't know that she can really learn any flying type moves. So, although I guess Salamam can. So, yeah, never mind. Completely forgot I was riding a Charizard there for a second. Alright, seriously? No grass types anywhere? I suppose flying types also work for an ice type. 19's a little low. Staravia, well, it's also 19, but I totally whiffed on that. Okay. Well, that's fine. Magikarp. But, yeah. I think considering replacing Tumbelina wouldn't be a terrible idea. An eject button. Okay, cool. So long and thanks for all the fish. I'm out. So yeah, types. I'm not sure what we would replace Tumbelina with. As I mentioned, we don't have a fighting type, but what advantages does a fighting type really give me? There's a Chikorita. Some Hoppips. I thought that was a blue Hoppip for a sec. Okay, well, that was... Ideally, I could find some Skiplooms or Jumpips. Jumpluffs. Jumpips. Oh my god. But yeah. So, for types. So let's see, what do we not have? We don't have a fighting type. Fighting types give me an advantage over normal types, which I guess I don't have. Normal type really is only weak to fighting types, oddly enough. I don't know that I've been in that ice biome before, so I'm just gonna fly across this little ravine here. And then we're just gonna stay away from it again, because we don't really need to go across there. Hitting flyers is a little difficult from the ground, so let's not worry too much about that. What kind of Pokeballs do I have on me? I have quite a few types. I was just thinking if we run into, like, Rayquaza or something. What level is this Staravia? 27? Oh, there we go. That's a fight. Okay. There we go. Oh, ow. Okay, that barely did anything. Alright, well, it's getting dark, so let's just get back on Salamam and head back up towards where we're supposed to be. Where are we supposed to be? Heading north. There's a Gloom. That would have been nice to find earlier. I got some vanilla Minecraft music here going, which I guess is better than nothing. But yeah. Alright, so let's head over to the center here. I just want to fix... Well, no, you know what? We're wasting time. Let's just go. Salamam's at full health. That's all that really matters for this part. Okay, looking for Sneasels. So I can make some Weaviles. Hey, Weavile. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. It'd probably be better off just walking through the forest. Tree coverage is a little rough. So yeah, fighting types would help with normal types, ice types, rock types. Rock and ice we already got covered, really. Did I just see... No, it's probably just a poppy that I thought I saw. As a Sneasel feather. Should really focus on, like, its blue coat. I mean, it is a coat, right? Like, it's... Sneasel's what? It's a Weevil? Is it a Weevil? What is a Sneasel? I assume it's a Weevil because of Weavile, but... Weavile came much later than Sneasel. What else would Sneasel be? Like a Minx or something? I don't know. A ferret? It could be another ferret. They could have made two ferrets in this generation, in Gen 2. Go ahead, make Ferret and Sneasel. Maybe, perhaps. Could be. I don't know. Okay, so I'm not finding much walking around, so... We will take to the skies here a little bit. See what we can't spot from up here. And I can tell you right now, what we spot is not much. There's some Sneasels. Alright. Level 14. Flame Burst. Okay, that's a piece of ice. Level 24. Flame Burst. Nothing. Okay. That's a Wubbuffet. Not quite what we're looking for. Why was I talking about what Sneasel was? Oh, right, because I called its body color a coat. Or a blue coat. Because I assume it's got fur on it, as opposed to skin or scales. Definitely not scales. That much I know for sure. For sure, Sneasel's not a scaly beast. But as for what exactly it is, I don't know. So, I'm gonna stick with coat. It's got a coat. Now, I might be better off on the other one, honestly. How far away is it? It's a little ways away. It's the middle of the night, I got time. I have plenty of time. There's the Sneasel Cold Taiga, so we'll just head directly for that point. And we'll see where that gets us. Alright, yeah, that didn't take any time at all. Thanks to having a flyer on us, and there's another Sneasel. Lovely. So I need to find two of these items that they drop, I guess. That's gonna make this take a while. Fortunately, Salamam can use the levels. I could use the time. And, well, that's about that. Although, maybe I will check if steel is super effective against ice. Might not be a bad thing to test while we're here. I know for a fact it's not super effective against dark, so If it does say super effective, I'll know why. It'll be the ice, not the dark type. I don't think water resists metal either, or steel. Have I been calling it metal this whole time? If I have, I apologize. I know it's steel. Man, not common, Sneasels. That's a shame. This is taking quite a while. Thought a bigger forest would increase my chances, but perhaps not. Maybe I would have been better off getting a rideable mount. Like an earth-based mount, as opposed to trying to fly above this tree line. Although, lots of stupid damage happens when you ride a riding mount. Man, really, eh? No Sneasels anywhere. Fortresses are at this point more common. Well, that's not true. We fought four Sneasels. So, four Sneasels? Three Sneasels, I think. Man, not much out here. Okay. Wow, Buffett. Am I going too fast? Is that the issue? Let's go for a walk. Let's go for a walk. Okay. So yeah, the reason we're going for a Weavile. Oh, what did I hear? The reason we're going for a Weavile is literally just so it has better stats as it develops. Because I feel like that might have been one of the reasons we lost our last Sneasel, was it just didn't have the stats to stack up against its opponent. I don't even remember how we lost Claws. Poor thing. Flame Burst! And we got another piece of ice. Yes, so this is definitely not the most efficient method of grinding these things. But it's really the only option I've got. I can do more of this off camera as well as on if things go well. Although, as of right now, it does not appear that that is the case. Alrighty then. In that case, what ability do you have? Magnet Pull. Prevents steel types from escaping. Oh, there we go. Lucky. One more. And then the night is done. The night is done, for it is no longer young. That is a Pineco. I would love a fortress, honestly. Steel bug type? Pretty solid. Pretty solid. Although that's technically not a Pineco, that's the fortress, what it evolves into. I'm pretty sure it's just a bug type as a Pineco. But nonetheless, you get the idea. Any ice types I can fight in here that I can test the steel advantage of? Sneasel still spawns in the day? Really? That's good to know. Unless this guy spawned during the night. Quick claws, that's what they're called. Oh no, that's a different item. That's a different item. It's not the item I'm looking for. It's a good item though. There's another Sneasel. Maybe they do still spawn during the day. In that case, I'm just gonna keep running around. Magnemite. There you go. There is another one. 32. Okay, now I'm level 38 with Salamam. Pretty good. Looks like they're still spawning, so that's nice. I don't know why. I'm pretty sure they were only a nighttime spawn, but I'm not complaining. If there are still Sneasel to fight, I will fight. I don't think there are any pure ice types I could fight. I could fight Jinxes with the Sneasel. With Shade. Shade, the not quite feminine name, but passably unisex name. Honestly, it's a little bit more original than Tumbelina, I have to say. Criticizing myself, you know. It's turning into a long day when that starts happening. Nah, we'll be okay. Where was I going? I was heading towards that center. That was the plan, anyway. Where did it go? Did I overshoot it? I don't think I did. Maybe I did. Okay. It's, oh, well, that's painful. Some Sveal enjoying the ice. Or a Sveal. There we go, there's the center. There's another Articuno shrine. Lovely. I need to start fighting bosses a little more frequently. Alright, so we were talking about replacing Tumbelina. Who would we replace Tumbelina with? We've got... We've got no real need for a bug type. We've got water covered. We've got electric covered. We've got no real need for a bug again. We've got water covered. We don't really have... Oh no, we do have ice covered now. That's true. We have both ice and ground covered. Don't really need a poison type. Do I? I don't think Glissor's in this game anyway, so... Magmar, we've already got a fire type. Diglett, we already got a ground type. Ponyta, already got a fire. We don't have a grass type. What would a grass type be good for? Water, which we already have electricity. Rock and ground, which we already have. We have steel for rock types, although that's always a little scary. We've got water for rock types, although she only knows water gun. We've got ground type coverage from Drago for rock types, but for ground types, like a pure ground like Tumbelina, we have ice. Ice, ice water, water, steel eventually. Yeah, it looks like we just don't have a good thing to replace Tumbelina with. So what am I missing? Do we have fairy types in this? Is that a thing? I don't know that that's a thing yet. I don't know that you're even fairy type. Ice flying. I don't think I have anybody that qualifies. Actually, hold on. Doesn't Meryl qualify as a fairy type? Maybe not. Maybe not. I don't think fairy is in this. So what else do we have? So we're gonna have a ground dragon. We have a water flying. We have a fire flying. We have an electric steel. And we have a dark ice. So we don't have a psychic. Psychic would help against fighting types. Sure. We don't have a poison type. Poison would be good against grass types. And what else is poison good against? Poison is good against just grass, really? Is that it? I think that's it. Okay. We don't have a fighting type. Fighting would be good against dark, normal. It's the only thing that's good against normal. Good against rock. Ice. Ice, dark, normal, rock. Ice, dark, normal, rock, and anything else? I don't think so. Oh, I think it's good against steel type too, so. Fighting wouldn't be terrible. Ghost type would be good against psychic and ghost. Yeah. That's not great. What else am I missing? What else am I missing? Okay, so then let's look at this. Okay, then let's look at this from a practical standpoint then. We've got Tank in Pyra, who's got incredibly high defense. Let's go stats here. You have good speed. You're not really going to hit your stride until you're a Flygon anyway, so. You've got great attack. Okay. Good defense, but you're the one we're looking on replacing. Okay, special defense, I guess. Oh, defense is your... that's annoying. Okay, well, it's still alright. And then you are a fast attacker. What about status ailments? What could I do with that? Like, I could do a Gengar with Toxic, Confuse Ray. Double Team. And what else? I can't do a Gengar because we don't trade. Do a Golbat with that same setup. Golbat learns Double Team naturally, right? So that would make things easier. Oh wow, we're like super overtime right now. So that's actually going to have to do it for this one, so thank you all for watching. I hope you've enjoyed all that fun stuff. As always, if you did enjoy, please consider leaving a like or a comment. Any and all feedback is always very much appreciated. Helps me out a ton. And I do always love hearing from you guys. And I will see you all in the next episode. Ooh, Razor Claw. That's what we're looking for. See you then. Bye for now.